I am Lily Joseph, belong to the Society of the Daughters of the Heart of Mary. They started in France during French Revolution. I have come from one of the villages in Kerala, and we are 9 children at home. I am the 6th and among the girls youngest. I studied in a convent school. There, when I was studying, I had some attraction towards the sisters, especially of their dealings with the students and their praying together. It touched me a lot. I nurtured this in my heart. As a child, I had a habit of reading a lot. Once I happened to read an article in Malayala Manorama Weekly about Vimla Welfare Center and the Vimlalayam sisters. It touched me a lot, and there is a question mark came in, why not there? As I reached my 10th standard, my mother was very sick. I had to drop my schooling and look after her, being with her. And at month of May, she died. Then I continued my studies. In October, I passed my 10th standard. Then the family members had a question about my higher studies. I was not so interested in my higher studies in the college. At the most, I would in mind of going to senior tutorial, but my family did not agree with it. They put me in the government college, which is close by to mother house. As I finished my 12th standard, my struggle started, how to inform my people regarding my decision. I spoke to my parish priest. He told me, your father will never send you. Then I got an idea to write a letter to my sister. I wrote a letter to my sister. In that, clearly I have mentioned I want to be a missionary. I told my father, you read the letter and post it. He did not post it. He called my sister home, and they all of them tried to brainwash me. I did not fall into it. I was quite firm with my decision. Then he sent me to our relatives, priest and religious, to speak to me. I spoke to them. They also got convinced with my decision, and they told my father, it is better to allow her to go where she wants to go. Then he called his sister, my aunt, and my aunt came with one of the daughters of the Heart of Mary, Gracie Xavier. She too tried to brainwash me to go for higher studies. I said no. Then she asked me to come to Vimlalayam. So my aunt took me to Vimlalayam. They gave me a date to come. So my family members and my aunt came to reach me to Vimlalayam, but my father was feeling very sad and he could not come. We 8 of us started together. And now I would like to say a little about our congregation. Our society began in France during the French Revolution. All religious orders were banned and suppressed, persecuted. It was a great challenge to live a consecrated life at that time. Attentive to the Holy Spirit, both our founders, Marie Adelaide de Sisse and Father Peter Joseph de Clourvier SJ, saw a different plan to preserve the religious life without any exterior sign, without living together, but often meet together and share our experiences and encourage each other. The society has taken into shape on February 2, 1791. Our motto is to work for the glory of God in service to the humanity. We are called to live the essentials of religious life, which is the vows of chastity, poverty, and of obedience. An authentic religious life in the midst of the world. Community life is not the must in our society. We live in the community, outside the community. It all depends on our ministry. Anywhere we are called by the bishops, we take up the ministry according to the need of the time and the place. We are working with education. It means not only schools or colleges, but there are boardings for girls, then health care, prison ministry, family apostolate, working with mentally challenged children, working women's hostel, counseling centers, work with elderly and shelter home for girls, networking and collaborating with governmental and non-governmental organizations, working with street children, work with HIV/AIDS patients, childline, alcoholics. Since we do not have any particular apostolate, we are known like the sisters with the name of the house, like Nirmala Niketan, Roshni Nilaya, Vimla Alayam, Institute of Education. And we also do not call by sister. Most of us are addressed by Miss so and so. We are also available to look after our parents when they are old and need of our help. Especially, we are allowed to be with them as long as they are in need. Knowing all this, I continued my formation in Mumbai. As I started my formation, my sister came from Switzerland to take me back. But I was quite firm with the call which I received. I told my sister no, and I continued, and she went back with her upset mind. But that did not affect me. I was really happy in heart to heart. Finally, the day came. I was given the permission to make my first commitment. It was August 15th, 1980. My heart was thrilled. I was very happy. I made my first commitment. After the commitment, I was not so interested in any further studies. But the provincial superior asked me, there is a need for nurses. Would you like to go for nursing? Happily, I agreed. I went for it. I came out in good marks and passed my nursing. After that, I too was asked, there is a need for nurses in Gujarat. Willingly, I agreed and I started my mission. There, it reminded me how I asked my father to be a missionary. There also, I too had certain difficulties of adjusting the climates and other. I overcome all that with the grace of God, and I'm happy I could work with this people in Gujarat for 23 years. I can say from my heart, I enjoyed with them to do the healing ministry in Gujarat. All missionaries and pioneers have responded to God's call. I would like to share two of our sisters who have done great works, one from India, one from Pakistan. You may know Miss Olinda Pereira. She is one of the pioneers in the field of education for women empowerment. She started Vishwas Trust, home-based center for elderly, and also organized Council of Catholic Women of India. She got awards, Outstanding Community Leader Award, Outstanding Manager Award in 2011. She was founder of Roshni Nilaya School of Social Work. Dr. Ruth Pfau, a German-Pakistani daughter of the Heart of Mary, who devoted 55 years of her life fighting with leprosy patients in Pakistan. Mary Adelaide Leprosy Center was founded by her in 1963. Daughters of the Heart of Mary continues their journey of 230 years by fulfilling the will of God and serving the humanity. After hearing all this, do you feel God is calling you to be a daughter of the Heart of Mary? To be a God's evangelizer, to spread the peace and harmony, stand for social justice in today's world? If yes, if you want to know more about the society, please contact the following phone number and the address.